In Nicaragua, Reagan's crusade against the Sandinistas was stepped up.
Sandinistas desperately needed to get hard currency for their exports to pay off their bank loans. So this was a time to put the mines into Corinto. They only got one harbor that counts. And at the same time, make sure we notify Lloyd's of London. The mines have gone in, so hopefully they put pressure on the shipping company as well to stay out of there. Well, it worked.
Nicaragua's precious stock of oil went up in smoke. The economy was reeling, and all the while, ways had to be found to contain the US-backed Contra invasion. The Sandinistas asked the Soviets for help.
Leaders in Moscow did not want to provoke the United States into giving more military aid to the Contras and to the Kandurangam. Therefore, these requests were politely denied every time the Sandinistas brought it up in Moscow.
The Sandinistas, with help from Cuba, vowed to defend their borders and the revolution.
The success of communism in Central America poses the threat that 100 million people from Panama to the open border on our south could come under the control of pro-Soviet regimes.
Angry at Reagan's continued support for the Contra War, the U.S. Congress, again led by Representative Boland, voted in October 1984 to deny them any further assistance.
With the passage of the Boland Amendments, which ultimately prohibited assistance to the Contras, there was nothing more we could do than to bide our time.
To help pay for the continuing bloodshed in Nicaragua, Reagan's men secretly sold arms to Iran. The American dollar and the failures of the armed left crushed Latin American revolutionary dreams.
The United States saw a threat to their interests because they thought it was a communist struggle. They didn't see us as citizens who wanted a democratic country where there was social justice and which offered opportunities to the majority.
The Cold War cost Latin America the lives of hundreds of thousands of people. In Nicaragua alone, 50,000 died in the Sandinista Revolution and another 50,000 died in the Civil War. It was atrocious.
There were a lot of deaths, a lot of suffering, a lot of refugees, a lot of population movements. On the other hand, I think an equally, if not more compelling case can be made that had we not done something to stop communist regimes from being established in the other Central American countries other than Nicaragua, say that they'd been established in El Salvador and then in Guatemala and possibly even Honduras during the 1980s, if we hadn't taken the steps that we took, I think the immediate suffering could have even been considerably greater.
1990, Sandinista leader Daniel Ortega asks the Nicaraguan people to vote him president. Former U.S. President Jimmy Carter was there to see fair play. Violeta Chamorro, Ortega's opponent, narrowly won a surprise victory. Washington spent nearly $10 million backing her campaign.